This should be fine.
We're hoping. And you twist it there. Perfect.
Yeah, I know. But it doesn't seem to screw up.
It doesn't. Maybe we should officially begin. The Arts Council, but I'm also one of the three staff members who kind of work and run and organize the gallery program. And it wasn't very long after we'd opened that John came to Jeff with an idea for an exhibition, said I'm part of a group of artists, and let's kind of open a conversation about having a circular exhibition. So it's understandably Tuesday lunch is appropriate.
And it's really my first foray into conceptual art. I thought that the show, being so conceptual, really called for that. And I gave a lot of thought to different ways to approach it. I usually do drawings, paintings, and I have ventured into some wire sculpture. But when John mentioned reinventing the wheel, the first thing that came to mind, for some reason, was Cheerios. I thought of the little wheels of Cheerios. And I was envisioning doing a very large installation on the floor with Cheerios. I was discouraged when we thought about the practicality of it and the little mice that might be invited. So I moved on from that. And one day, round and round, while wrapping, there was something about the motion of wrapping. So I really was thinking about the wheel. When I saw it, I thought, I have a wheel. I have a new wheel. In fact, it's reinvented itself.
With this piece, my intention was for people to come up to the piece and not know what it was exactly. And then you come up and you see that actually the shadows are more important than the beads. So the word dot.
And so when it gets tangled, it doesn't spell out dots.
Well, what happens is it's an interactive piece, and people don't realize that that one's to be played with. This one was to be left alone, and we showed that was a sign that said, please do not touch this one.
And it just takes a little bit of a breeze before they start to.
It's good now.
Yeah, it's very good.
It's actually spelling dot.
Such a blow on it.